matter is, I've said it before, but for those who haven't heard it, I want to explain to you why Marvel Comics is very factual and scientific, and while why DC, they're not that scientifically accurate. I'm going to give you a good example, speaking of Superman. Superman flies, right?
Yes.
With no visible means of propulsion. All he does, he goes like this. And he flies. Now we get to Marvel. I wanted Thor, the Thunder God, to fly. I wasn't going to have him go like this. I decided he has a hammer. I have a leather thong that attaches to his wrist. He swings that hammer like a propeller. Then he lets it go. Well, it's attached to his wrist. The hammer flies off and it takes him with it. When Thor flies, it's based on an accurate scientific principle. Character like super whatever it is. Superman. The Marvel character.
But we have to accept that he's using a hammer to fly, so I'm not sure what hammer we can scientifically say you could throw and it would let you fly.
No. He's not simply saying to his hammer, go fly. He's whirling it like a... You've heard of propellers or what did the propeller do in the front of the plane?
Oh, absolutely, we understand.
But I don't want to be cruel and have you go down totally into defeat. I'll admit that perhaps only Thor could fly by swinging a hammer. The average guy couldn't get away with it.
I don't say he's a defeat.
But the average guy, couldn't become the Hulk just on account of being near a gamma ray, so... But we try to be scientific. More than I can say for a certain company.